Hello, today's video is going to be about, that's right, breadboard. I wonder how you guessed that. This is a challenge video. Sergey, I hope that your video will receive enough of views. Can't wait to see your video that you're going to upload to YouTube. And this is my video. As you can see, there are lots of kind of breadboards. This is a small one for simple connection. This is a bigger one, and this is the most frequent and common type, which got two power rails and two connection rails. The voltage on each of the power rails can be different. They are mostly used with this module, which can supply either a 3.3 volts or a 5 volts. The settings of the voltage is achieved by tampering with the jumpers. The most important stuff about this breadboard are the columns. As you can see, J1 is interconnected with F1. But J2 is not connected to J1 or any of these columns. The rows are separated. Only the columns are attached. The main problems with working with such a breadboard is that in theory you prepare the circuit, you assemble it on the breadboard, but for some odd reason it simply doesn't work. The most important thing that you need to do is to press on the electrical components, because sometimes on the cheap breadboards, I assume that even on the more expensive ones, the connections aren't that well. You really need to press those deep ICs or the LEDs or the resistors or any other component that you are going to use. Well, that was a short video about breadboards. Oh, I almost forgot. The power rails can be detached from the breadboard. And you can also attach several breadboards to achieve a bigger one. Have fun!